Like the
go.
Hold on, I'm picking up something. Behind.
Hi guys, today we are going to build a custom video player using HTML, CSS and JavaScript. Okay, so this is what the player we are going to build. So I have taken the screenshot of this. As you can see, we are having all the functionality, the volume functionality here and the seek bar and the buttons here and the full screen button here. So we are going to code this from scratch. Okay, so this is the index.html file. And by the way, we are going to play a complete movie. This is a Despicable Me movie. I'm going to play in the video player. The reason I'm playing the movie is because I want to calculate the movie duration for 1 hour, more than an hour. Okay, so I could have played with a minutes or seconds video, but I just want to try it with a complete movie here. Fine. So this is the movie we are going to play using custom player. Fine. So this is the index.html file, and this is my index.html in the code editor. So I have included the fontawesome library here, jQuery, and my custom script file. So this is the custom CSS file. So my custom style.css file and the script file here. Okay. So let's get started now. So first I'm going to write a div with a class of container. So inside the container, we are going to have div with class of video player, and I'm going to add another class for this. So this class helps us, show controls class helps us in showing the controls when the mouse is hovered on the video. So this is used for the controls. Okay. So we'll be manipulating through JavaScript to show and hide the controls here. Fine. So this is the video title section. So I'm going to write a div with a class of video title. So inside the title we'll be having. So I'm writing lorem ipsum for now. Okay. And we are going to have a video tag. The source is video/2.mp4. So this is the video I'm having in the 2.mp4. Okay. So this is a despicable move here. Fine. Next we are going to have controls. So div.controls, and I'm going to add a class called active here. The reason I'm adding active class because I'm going to manipulate this class using JavaScript again. Fine. So inside the controls, we are having two sections here. So this is the control section, and the top section consists of the start time, the seek bar, and the end time here. And the bottom controls are having the volume control section and our buttons and the full screen video section here. Fine. So we are having two sections here. One is top controls. So the top controls will be having div.topControls. So inside the top controls we'll be having start time. So I'm setting this manually, but we'll make it dynamic using JavaScript. Okay. So let's see the reference here. So this is the start time I have coded. Next we are having a seek bar. Div.seekbar. So inside the seek bar we'll be having this progress bar. So which progresses as the video plays. Fine. So inside the seek bar I'm going to have a progress bar. Fine. And similarly we'll be having an end time. So span dot end time. Even we'll calculate this using JS. Fine. So we are done with the top controls. Next the bottom controls. So if you see the reference here, the bottom controls are having the volume control section, and the controls, all the playback controls here, and the full screen button here. Okay, so I'm going to write div with the class of bottom controls. So inside the bottom controls, I'm going to write another div with the class of, for volume controls, I'm doing this with the class of volume CTRL. Okay, we are having volume controls. So if you see the volume control, we are having an icon here and the sig bar section. Okay, so dot icon. So this icon will be holding the volume icon here. i.fa hyphen volume hyphen up. So I'm not going to animate this icon. I'm going to leave this as is. And we are, the other section is the sig bar section for the volume control. So I'm going to add another div with the class of sig bar section. So sig bar section, we are having two things here, the volume and the percentage we want to indicate, and the sig bar and the progress bar here, progress bar. Fine. So inside the sig bar, I'm going to create a wrapper. So the wrapper will be having two spans. One, this is a label. So the volume here, this is the label I'm using. LBL is the class I'm using for the volume label there. And span dot percentage. So this is the class I'm using for the percentage. So 100%. Initially we are setting it to 100%. Okay. So after the wrapper, so this is the wrapper. So we are done with this. Next we are having a sig bar which contains a progress bar. So I'm going to write div with class of sig bar and progress bar. Okay, so we are done with that. So this should be a span. Let this be a span, right? So we are done with this section. Next we are going to choose the playback control section. So after the volume control, after the volume control, we are having playback section here, playback controls. So I am going to have another div with the class of playback controls, where I'll be having three buttons. So one is for a backward, and one is for a fast forward, and for the play button. Fine. So let's write a div with the class of playback control. So inside the playback control, we are having a button, three buttons. The first button, I'm going to give a class of btn and backward. Okay. So I'm going to add an icon here, fa-fast-backward. So this is the font awesome class. So let's see the result here first. Right now the video is taking complete. This is a pure HD video, that is the reason it is taking complete space here. We'll be controlling using CSS later. Fine. So this is our volume control button and the backward button. And we are having another button. So this button will be having classes of BTN and play, pause, button and play. So these are the classes we are going to assign for this. So this will be having two icons inside this. One is for a play So when there is a play class applied on this button, this play phantasm icon is visible. And similarly, fa.fa-pause. So when there is a pause class on this button, the pause icon will be visible. So this will be controlled using CSS. Okay. And similarly, we are going to have another button. So that is for fast forward. Okay. I'm going to assign a same class btn and forward. fa.fa-fast-forward. Okay. So let's see the result. As you can see, the backward, fast forward, and the play and pause button, and the fast forward button. Okay. And the last we are having an icon here for the full screen. So full screen. So this will be having a div with a class of full screen control, and inside that I'm going to have a button with a class of full screen. Okay. And inside this, I am going to write a phantasm icon, fa-expand. Okay, click on save. Let's see the result here. So this is the full screen icon. So right now, it is ugly. So let's style this using CSS. Okay. So I am quickly jumping to my style.acss file here. First, let me add some random Google font and assign it to a variable so that I can use it multiple places. Fine. And we are going to have a colors. One is for black and another going to be the controls color. So all the controls will be of the same color. So ACAFB6. So lightish gray I'm using here, and for the white it is 1 2 3 4 5 6, all Fs. Fine. So we want to show some easing effect when the mouse is hovered on the player while it is playing. So for the controls, to get smooth effect, I'm using a mixin for transitions here. The transition all is 0.2 seconds. So later I'll be including this mixin at various places. Okay. So let's get started. I'm targeting the body here and setting the font family to my font family variable and setting the background color initially to lighten black 80%. Okay, as you can see, the background is lightish gray, and I'm directing the container. So I'm directing the container here. So initially setting the position to fixed, set the top to 0, bottom to 0, left to 0, and right to 0, and margin to auto. Will display the element as flex, and justify content to center, and align items to center. Fine. Okay, next we'll target the video player. So I'm copying the class here. We'll set the max width property on this element to 800 pixels. Okay. As you can see, this is the video. Its max width is 800 pixels. And we'll set the border radius to 4 pixel. And we'll apply the overflow property to hidden. This is because to hide the controls, we'll display the element as flex. and align items to center. We'll apply the position to relative and we'll set the background color to the black, and we'll apply some box shadow on this element. 0 pixel, 10 pixel, 20 pixel, RGBA, color black, 0.5. Fine. Next, we are going to target the video title. We'll set the position to absolute. And set the left to 0, right to 0, and margin to auto. Right now we are styling the title here, so I'm making it as absolute, and when we hover the mouse on this video we will show the elements. If not, we'll just push them out of the videos there. Okay, video container. Fine. And I'm applying some z-index property. Because it is positioned absolute, we can apply the z-index here, setting the z-index to 100 and setting the top to -50%, so that it is pushed out of the screen completely. Okay, let me set the border so that it is visible. Let me set the video's width first. Okay, so video, set the max width on this element directly to 100%. Okay, so if I set like this, as you can see, this is the video title. So this is the video title. Okay, it is positioned absolute. Fine. And initially we are having top of -50%. We'll apply some padding on this video title. So padding is 0.5 rems, and we'll justify the content to center and display the element as flex. Set the background color to RGBA, dollar black, 0.6%. Fine. The color is RGBA, dollar white, 0.8, and we'll apply text transform property to uppercase. So right now it is not visible. Basically what we have done is we have set the background color to some transparent using the background color RGBA function and applied the color property on this element so that the text is also transparent. Fine. And we are applying some padding. Let me remove the border. Fine. The next thing we need to do is we need to make use of this class, the showControls class. So when this class is applied, we want the elements, we want the video title as well as the controls to be shown. So to do that, inside the video player I'm using an AND. So when these two classes are applied, we want the video title to be pushed from top -50% to 0, because initially it is having top -50%. So when this class is applied, the video title will be at 0, and similarly the controls which we'll be coding now, we'll set the bottom to 0. Similarly with title, we'll push the controls to the bottom, and when we hover the element we will push them from the bottom. Okay, so I'm targeting the controls section. So this is what I'm going to target, all the controls. So inside the video player, video player dot controls. So all the controls will be handled here. So initially we'll set the position to absolute and set the bottom to -50%. Just like the top -50%, I'm using bottom -50%, setting the left to 0, right to 0, and margin auto will display the element as flex, and we'll set the flex direction to column. Let's see here. So initially I'll set the bottom to 0, but we'll change this to -50%. Okay, let me add a border so that it is visible. Border 1 pixel solid $white. So this is our control section completely. Okay, so this is the start time. It isn't visible, the start time and the end time and all are present here. So we'll just slowly code this and we'll justify the content to center. Similarly, we'll apply z index on this element also. Set the background color to RGBA $black, so 0.6%. Okay. And for the top controls, for these top controls, I'm going to target the top control section. As you can see here, the top controls. So inside the top controls, we'll set the padding to 1 rem, and we'll position the element as relative. And similarly, we'll set the bottom controls. So bottom controls consists of all these elements. So this is the top controls and this is the bottom controls we are coding right now. So the bottom controls will apply some padding on this element, 0.5 rem and 2 rems, and will display the element as flex. So the reason I am referring to the image here is it isn't visible here clearly. As you can see, so I'm referring this to get a clear idea. So what we are doing, okay? We'll justify the content to space between and position them to relative. Okay. So space between gives us this entire thing is wrapped in one section. These three buttons are wrapped in another section, and this full screen button is wrapped in another section. So space between gives L and these elements equally. Fine. So let's start coding the top control section. Dot top controls. So initially top controls are not having any elements here. Let me first change the color to white. So right now these are the visible items now. So we want the start time to be at left position as shown here, left position. Next we want the progress bar and the end time here. End time should be at right. So inside the top controls, what I'm going to do is we'll display the element as flex first, and we'll justify the content to space between, and we'll align items to center. Okay, so as you can see, the start time and the end time are pushed at ends. Okay, we'll target the start time as well as the end time. We'll set the flex basis property on these elements to 10%. and we'll set the flex string to 1. Okay, we'll display the elements as inline flex and justify content to a center and set the color to control color. Okay, and we are going to style the sig bar now. Initially we'll set the height to 6 pixel. Let me add some border so that it is visible. So this is our sig bar. So to get its full width, we'll set the flex basis property on this element to 80%. Okay, as you can see, the sig bar is full stretched here. Next, we are going to set some border radius on this element. Set the border radius to 5 pixel and we'll display the element as flex. Okay. Next, we are going to work with the progress bar. So, targeting the progress bar, so which is inside the sig bar. Okay. So, this is what we are targeting now. What we'll be doing here is we'll set the height to 100%, so it occupies the full height of the element, and we are going to manipulate the width. Right now I'm setting it to 50%, but we'll manipulate the element with the JavaScript. So basically we want to show the progress, that is the reason I'm using the width here. So we'll set the background color to RGBA dollar white 0.6%, 0.6. Okay, and we'll set the border radius on this element also to 5 pixel. We'll position the element as relative and display it as inline flex. Okay, let's see. So this is the progress bar. So let me remove the sig bar red color and apply background color on this element. So background color is RGBA dollar controls color comma 0.6. I'm removing this border here. As you can see, this is the progress bar and this is the sig bar, and we want to provide user feedback. So when we hover on this element, what I'm going to do is I'm making use of the after pseudo class, and I'm going to create a simple dot. Okay, let me show you how it is. Setting the position to absolute and set the height to 4 pixel and also the width to 4 pixel, top to 0, bottom to 0, and set the margin to auto and right to minus 4 pixel, and border radius to some high value. Okay, and what I'm going to do is when we hover on this sig bar, so I'm using and hover class here. So when we hover on this sig bar, we'll set the cursor to pointer, and the progress bar after element will increase the height to 10 pixel and also width to 10 pixel. So let me show how it looks. Setting the background color to RGBA dollar white 1. Okay, so if I hover on this element, as you can see, the circle gets here. So when I am not hovering on this element, it looks just normal, but when I hover on this sig bar, as you can see, there is a little dot that appears here. So we don't want this to happen immediately. we are going to include our mix in. Let's give this a try. So when I hover on the seek bar, the dot appears slowly there. Okay. Next, we are going to work with the bottom controls. We are done with the top controls. So I'm setting the bottom controls class here. So the bottom controls we are having the volume section and the playback controls and the full screen. So first we'll target the volume control. So inside the volume controls we'll display the element as inline flex and we'll align items to center. And set the flex basis property to 15%. Okay, so this is the volume section here. We need to design it like this. Okay, so let me add border so it is visible. Solid white. So this is the volume section here. Right now we are having an icon. So what we are going to do is we'll justify the elements to be space between. We'll target the icon. We'll set the color to controls color and we'll apply some margin right on this element, 0.5 rems. And set the font size on this element to 1.2 rems. Okay. So now we'll target the seek bar section. So we are targeting the seek bar section where we are having a label and the percentage. Okay. So first we'll display the element as inline flex and we'll make the flex direction to column and flex basis to 80%. Okay, and we are targeting the wrapper. We'll display them as inline flex again and justify the content to space between. Okay, so the volume and the percentage are aligned here. Next we'll align the seek bar, the label and the percentage just as this. Okay, so we are targeting the label dot lbl and percentage. Sorry, this should be a comma here. So we are targeting the label and the percentage. We'll set the font size on these elements to 0.8 rems and the color to be controls color and we'll text transform it to capitalize. As you can see, the volume and the 100% are font size are bit low. Fine. Now the next thing is we need to create this progress bar, the seek bar as well as the progress bar there. So after the wrapper, click on seek bar. Write the seek bar class there and we'll set the margin top to two pixel so that there is a space between the volume and the seek bar there. That is the reason I'm using margin top. Okay, and we'll display the element as inline flex set the initial height to 5 pixel and border radius to 2 pixel. Okay, so flex space is to be 100%, and set the background color just as the seek bar. I'm using RGBA controls color 0.6. Okay, and after the seek bar, we need to target the progress bar. Okay, so initially we'll set the height to 100% just as the seek bar. Width also to 100% and set the background color to RGBA dollar white 0.6. So if I click on save, as you can see the width is 100%, the progress bar is filled there. Let me remove the border so it is clearly visible. Okay, and similarly we'll set the border radius on this element. So border radius to 2 pixel and targeting the after pseudo class here, we'll set the content to empty, position to absolute and height to 4 pixel and also the width to 4 pixel, top to 0, bottom to 0. Just I want to create that dot in front of it, that is the reason I'm using this. So right to minus 4 pixel and set the margin to auto, background color to be RGBA dollar white and border radius to be 500 pixel. Okay, so it is up to you how you want to stylize all these elements, so feel free to customize yourself. And when we hover on this progress bar, similarly we want to create some effect, so and colon hover, so when we hover the seek bar, we want to create this effect. Seek bar colon hover, we'll set the cursor to pointer and progress bar and colon colon after, we'll set the height to 10 pixel and also the width to 10 pixel and set the background color to, sorry I forgot the semicolon here, set the background color to RGBA dollar white. So this is completely for styling purpose, that is the reason I'm using it. So I forgot the after. Okay, so that dot is here at right, as you can see when I hover on this element. So we forgot to write the position relative on the seek bar section, maybe. So we'll set the position to relative and let's see. Okay, we don't want the right to be there, so let's set it to 0. Fine. Okay, fine. Just as like seek bar, we are having a volume control also. Next, we are going to target the playback controls here. So let me target the bottom controls dot playback again. So bottom controls. So inside the bottom controls, we are having a playback controls will make the flex basis to 70% and display them as inline flex. We'll justify content to space evenly. So we are targeting the buttons here. So we are having the backward button and forward play pause button, as well as the fast forward button. So I'm targeting the button globally, setting the font size on these elements directly. So font hyphen size to 2 rems. We'll set the background color to transparent, outline to 0, and set the border to none. So I click on save. As you can see, let's apply color on this element so that it is visible. So color controls color. Okay, so right now we are having the backward play pause button as well as the forward button. Next, we are going to I'm going to include a transition again, and on hover let's give the button first. Let's set the cursor to pointer, and similarly the font or some color will be the light and color of the controls color. Okay, so we'll be lightening them 20%. Okay, let's give this a try. As you can see, when I hover on this element, this gives a user a feedback. Fine, and yeah, as I told, when there is a play class applied on this element, we want the, so if I show you directly, right now I am having a play button on the play pause button here. Okay, so this is the button, play pause button. So when there is a play icon on this element, sorry, play class on this element, so we want the pause button to be hidden. And similarly, when there is a pause class on this button, we want the play icon to be hidden. Okay, so to do that, so when there is an play class, I want the pause to be displayed to set none. Fine. So right now the pause button is hidden completely. Similarly, when there is an pause class on this element, we want to apply some transform element, transform rotate 180 degrees. Let me show this in action. And we want the play button to be hidden. Okay, so we'll display them to none. Okay, so let me show this in action. So right now there is a play class on this element, so if I set to pause, as you can see the icon is changed to pause. And similarly, when I remove the pause and add the play class, as you can see we are getting a play icon there. So this is what I am going to manipulate using JavaScript. So these classes helps us in playing the video. Fine. The last thing we need to do is we need to target the forward and the backward icons. Okay, and dot forward comma dot and dot backward. So we'll set the font size on this element to 1.5 rems. Okay, so right now we are done with this. Next, the full screen control. I'm directing the bottom controls dot full screen control. We'll set the flex basis on this element again to 15%, and we'll display it as inline flex. We'll justify the content to flex end dot full screen. So this is the icon holder. As you can see, this is the button. Fine. We'll set the font size on this element to 1.2 rems, and we'll remove the border. So we don't want the border, and we don't want the background color. So we'll make it transparent. We'll set it to transparent, and the color to be font controls color font, and we'll remove the outline. So outline to 0, setting the outline to 0. And to provide a feedback, I'm using a hover class on this element, and set the cursor to pointer, and the icon color will be LIGHTAN lighten controls color 20%. Fine. The final thing is we need to remove the border on this element. Okay, so I have applied the white border. Let me remove the border. Okay, so we are having the controls. So inside the video player controls, let me remove the border and set the bottom back to -50%. Okay. Since there is a show controls class on this element, the controls are visible right now. So if there is no show controls class, the controls will be hidden. So even this we are going to manipulate using JavaScript. As you can see, when I have a show controls class on this element, both the title as well as the controls are visible. Fine. To make them smooth, let's do one thing. Let's include a transition on this element. And similarly for the controls, hit rate include transition. Okay, let's try again. So I'm removing the show controls class on the element, so they are hidden. So similarly, if I apply show controls class, they just pop up inside the video. Okay, so this is the part one of the video. In the part two, we'll completely write the JavaScript functionality for this player and play the video according to the controls. Okay, hope you enjoyed this video. Please do watch other videos on my channel. Please share and subscribe. We'll meet again with an exciting tutorial. Take care.